My name is Sarah Michal Hamid, and birth control saved my life. Before I begin, I'd like to provide a brief content warning that this video will discuss menstruation, extreme pain, and endometriosis. When I was about 12 years old, I had my first menstrual cycle, and from the onset, it was incredibly painful. I told those in my life that I was experiencing extreme symptoms and period pain, and it was often brushed off as part of becoming a woman and growing up. I would later learn that this wasn't normal and that this wasn't okay. The symptoms continued for about 3 years, and it wasn't until I was in high school and was about 15 years old that they started to worsen. I started experiencing dizzy spells, fainting, and extreme vomiting and nausea to the point where I couldn't even get up in the morning to go to school. That's when I knew that something was really serious. I went to my pediatrician, and again, I was told that this was normal and part of becoming a woman and that I should just take ibuprofen when the pain got really bad. But I knew that this wasn't the case. I knew that something wasn't right, and I knew that I needed to advocate for myself. I then saw an obstetrician gynecologist, or OBGYN, who again told me that these were normal symptoms for a teenage girl. Even still in this position where I'd seen already two doctors and clearly was in a great deal of pain, I started to believe what they were telling me. Even though the OBGYN recognized that these symptoms were normal, she recommended that I be put on prescription birth control, otherwise known as the pill. I started taking the pill and my pain wasn't as bad and I was able to get up in the mornings, which was a far cry from what my life was like before I started the pill. I continued to stay on this form of birth control until I was about 17 years old when I started college. My first couple months were fabulous and I had the most amazing time, and then my symptoms got worse. They got even worse than they had been before. I started experiencing blackouts, I wasn't able to go a day without vomiting in the morning, and I was feeling pain constantly daily. It got so bad to the point that I was rushed to the hospital and I did not know what to do. They wrote off my symptoms because I was sexually active, saying that these were likely side effects of an STI. I knew that this wasn't the case. But still, in that environment, I felt incredibly pressured to believe what the doctors had told me, but I knew that something was much worse. After that visit, I went to go see a regular OBGYN who again concluded with what the OBGYN in the emergency room had said. I voiced my concerns that I had been experiencing this level of pain throughout my life for over 5 years at that point, and still I was written off and told that I should just take the antibiotics that I had been provided. It got to the point where my pain came back again about a month later, and I was prescribed opiates in an amount that I couldn't even pick up myself at the pharmacy. I needed someone else to pick it up for me because at the time I wasn't 18. After that experience, I knew that I needed to find another doctor, and about a dozen doctors later, I found one who finally believed me, and she correctly diagnosed me with endometriosis, which is a disease in which the uterine lining escapes the uterus and grows adhesions on other parts of the pelvic cavity. When I met the doctor who correctly diagnosed me, she placed me on a new form of birth control that would manage the symptoms of endometriosis correctly. And I'm not even kidding, that pill saved my life. I went from having zero pain-free days to having at least 5 a week. And for someone living with chronic pain, that is amazing. I continued on that birth control pill until I had to have excision surgery for my endometriosis. But that pill managed my symptoms in the most efficient way that I have ever experienced in my life. I went from being a 17-year-old who had zero pain-free days and was in constant chronic pain to finally a young adult that could live her life. There's a great deal of pain in my story. There's even more pain in the fact that young people like myself aren't able to access the pill for life-saving and life-giving reasons because they don't have a prescription for it. I think of the thousands of other people who suffer with endometriosis and can correctly self-identify their symptoms but can't get access to a life-saving and life-giving medication because it is not available over the counter. I'm one of the lucky ones because I have health insurance and I was able to access a prescription for birth control through my primary care physician. There are thousands of others in the United States that aren't able to do so. And this has devastating effects on the lives of young people. I demand for access to over-the-counter birth control. We are the generation of the now, and we are the generation that will win. Free the pill now and forever, because our lives depend on it.